Welcome to my channel Mixed Media and More. I'm Bea and I'm glad you found me. Thank you for stopping again at my channel and welcome to another video hop. Join me while I make two big, easy and fun tags. Here I'm using the cut-off corner as a template for the other side. That way I get a symmetrical shape for the tag. And next I'm gonna mark the middle for punching a hole. I made them from some leftover watercolor paper. But you could use, for example, cardboard from a cereal box. In fact, with anything as long it is on the sturdy side and not too flimsy. Depending on what you use, you have to apply first a coat of gesso or white paint. A bunch of talented video creators came together again to inspire you. After watching my video, hop to the next artist's video by clicking in the first link down below. Watch each video and continue to click on the first link until you have reached my video again. That way you don't miss a ton of inspiration and fun. Here I have started sketching the first tag. As a reference, I have used some tags from last year, but you could go instead to the internet and search some reference pictures there. And yes, I'm not good at drawing perfect circles. So I'm looking for things which I can use as a template. Again, I did speed up the video and did edit out the boring things. Now enjoy watching me making tags. I will pop in again if I have something to say. If there are any questions or comments, leave them down below the video. So far I have used a 2B graphite pencil. Next I outline everything with a waterproof black marker. I'm gonna make sure that everything is dry before I erase the pencil lines by using a heat gun. Next, I grabbed some acrylic paint. Any brand will do. Just choose the colors you like. I seriously was thinking about the pink sheep, but nah, I kept it white. To give the sheep wool a little bit of structure, I did use a stipple brush. They have rather short and stiff bristles. Thank you. For this primitive text, I don't care so much for shading. For me, that's the charm of these folk paintings. It isn't realistic at all, so I usually just apply plain colors. Thank you. Now that I have painted everything, I go over again with the black marker. And I make sure that all the paint is dry before I start. Acrylic paint will ruin your markers if they are still wet. Again, I did use a heat gun to speed up the drying process. So, if you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Till next time! And here I'm adding a final touch by applying some black distress ink to the edges.